to His OJ, everyone's favorite Nigerian.
It's that real life shit, nigga.
All right, we're going to go right into it, man. My favorite game, real shit or weird shit. I sent you guys this article, Michael Ower. I don't even know how to pronounce his name. And I'll be
watching. You said it right.
All right. I'll be watching football enough, but Michael Ower and the Tuohy family, they, I definitely don't know how to say their name, but fuck them. So, real shit or weird shit? Did you guys read the article? Do you guys see, like, what's going on, what's happening?
Yeah.
Yeah, I read up on it. Just some read up on the articles. Definitely looking too, because the Blind Side, like when I watched that back, and I think back in high school, that was a good movie. Like I think
it was like 07, 08, something like that.
I know
when that movie came out.
When it came out, and you young, so you don't really realize like what it's doing. Like
yeah.
I tried watching it like when I was older. I was like, "Oh, this is a white savior movie." But, but like when you young, it's just like, "Oh, okay, that's how cool they taught this dude how to play football." Little do we know that this nigga already knew how to play football when they found him. He was already a football star. Was already getting recruited, and then on the movie they had like their little son who was like 5 years old teaching him plays with like condiments and shit like that. It's like,
yeah,
it's like, come on, bro, like that shit ain't happen,
right?
Yeah, I saw he was even talking about. The way he didn't really like how they depicted him in the movie, like he had never seen a bed before and stuff. Like, of course, like, you know, he had had a troubled upbringing, you know, his mom, I believe, you know, just dabbled in some, you know, different drugs and things like that. But
yeah,
they made it seem like he had literally never seen a bed. Like, if you've seen that movie, The Blind Side, like when he goes to their house, the way they dramatize that scene, I get it's a movie, but it's like, all right, don't make me like look super extra'd out, super crazy. So it's like, I don't know, man.
Right. I think he said that like in the locker room, they like he would have to explain like because people thought he couldn't read and write. So like he was saying in the locker room, people just assume that he couldn't read and like read and write. It's like, nah, I've been smart. I've been knowing how to do this. They didn't teach me that. But like, you know, he's like they played it up for the movie.
Yeah, that, man. That too. I was saying he is like an honor student over there at Ole Miss too. So it's not like he was a sloucher. You know, he wasn't articulate and didn't know, you know, about like his studies and like how to get good grades and stuff. So, yeah.
And if you don't know what we're talking about, pretty much there's an offensive lineman, you know, Hall of Fame caliber offensive lineman. This ain't no slouch. Like he's been nice. He's been that guy. Won the Super Bowl with the Ravens.
The Blind Side.
Been in the league since forever. Retired a couple years ago, several years ago. Pretty much there's a movie that came out depicting his life story. About like the family that pretty much brought him in and essentially like welcomed him into their home. Now it turns out that he's saying that they are profiting off his likeness. Everything was fake. Like they ain't even really adopt him like that, like they said they did. And maybe that's what's stemming from like everything. Like maybe he's just hurt by that. Like, oh, I'm not, y'all tricked me.
Yeah.
And the word came up, conservative shit.
Right.
We seen that shit with Britney Spears.
Yeah.
Like, You just want control of my likeness to profit off of me. And now I want to know, like, how much you really made off of me versus, like was shit really genuine, I guess.
Because exactly, Blind Side made over $300 million. And I think the family received, like 200K plus, like, two point five percent.
2% royalties, bro.
Yeah. He didn't get a penny of that. So...
in perpetuity too. That's crazy.
Yeah.
So the producers came out. They said that
that's crazy.
The family members only received about 700K in total, and that there wasn't like a stipulation to like receive royalty funds from the movie. But I mean, we'll really see like what they actually got if this like goes to trial and shit goes into, you know, discovery and shit like that. But so I'm assuming you guys are on the same side as me, but I want to hear y'all say it. Real shit or weird shit?
That's weird shit for sure.
Definitely Very weird shit, bro.
I think the extra weird shit about it too is like, you know, just even reading about like how the mom was going out and doing like all these public speaking gigs and like writing all these books on it. And, you know, you can't even really, over the years since that movie came out, I don't even know if you could, you know, that's going to be the hard part for him to prove in trial, like how much money she actually
made off him,
made off of that.
Yeah. Like, but it's like you wouldn't even have had any fame or notoriety.
Exactly.
If it wasn't for me.
Y'all would have just been a regular white ass family.
Facts, bro.
It's crazy.
Like their kids ain't do nothing, bro.
That shit crazy.
Yeah, nah.
So nah, we not with that white savior shit, bro. That shit is OD, and that shit's nah.
No, I was before that even came out, because I was like thinking, I was like, damn, The Blind Side was good, because I watched it when I was a teenager.
Talking to the mic.
Oh, sorry. When I was just thinking about that before the article came out, because I was like, damn, The Blind Side was a good movie. But you brought up a point where it's like, as a kid, you probably don't even notice it's a white savior movie. And I was like, you know, as like you start to get older, you think about it, it's like, damn, that definitely was the definition of a white savior movie. Now you hear to see this article come out.
And Sandra Bullock running onto the football field, dragging him by his helmet, telling him what to do. It's like, come on,
crazy, bro.
Like, nah.
You got Sandra Bullock at practice and shit, bro.
Shout out to Sandra Bullock, though. Like,
she just lost her husband, too, so it's kind of crazy. Okay, they throwing her name into all this. Damn. At the end of the day, she's just an actress, you know what I mean? She didn't know what was what, but they trying to, like, have her take responsibility for shit. Nah, this on the family, bro, so y'all stop being weird and do all them little social media games y'all love to do and canceling niggas and shit, like, Sandra's chill. We still rock with her. So.
Yeah, prayers for Sandra, man.
Yeah, come on now.
I hate to hear that.
Yeah, that's crazy.